What's up, bosses? Welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, my name is Alyssa, and this channel is all about entrepreneurship, marketing, and selling digital products. So I talk to a lot of Etsy sellers pretty much daily, and I am noticing a pattern of mistakes that a lot of sellers are making that are killing their sales or just not allowing them to even start making sales. So in this video today, I want to go over the top 6 mistakes that all Etsy sellers need to avoid. And I guarantee that there's at least one or two of these things that you are doing in your shop that's stopping you from making the amount of sales that you could potentially make. Before we jump in, I want to give a shout out to Amanda Panda Teacher. Go check her out on YouTube, Instagram, and go check out her Etsy shop. She's one of my students and she's absolutely amazing. So be sure to go check her out and give her a follow. And if you want a chance to be shouted out in my next video, then make sure you comment down below, take a screenshot of this video, and post it on Instagram stories. Don't forget to tag me at HeyLissaRose. Okay, without further ado, let's get into the video. So before you can fix any of these big 6 mistakes, you wanna make sure that your product idea is validated. I have a video all about that, so go check out that video first. But let's say you already have validated your product idea. If other people are selling a similar item successfully, then there's absolutely no reason why you can't do it too. So let's get into the 6 big mistakes that you might be making. Mistake number 1 is your listing descriptions and your photos are not clear from a shopper's perspective. So not everyone is going to take the time to message you when they're unclear about something in your product listing. So it's super important to make sure that not only your photos are professional and your listing descriptions look professional, but that also you're answering all potential questions that customers might have within your photos and within your listing description. If you don't do this, then it's very likely that shoppers won't message you and they're just gonna bounce off and go to one of your competitors who are more clear about what they're offering. So really make sure that you're including all the photos that you need to include in order to tell the whole story of what your potential customer is actually purchasing, and make sure you're super clear in your listing description. Now, there are a few things that you can do to understand if your photos and your listing descriptions are clear. So one way is you can try to look at your listings objectively. So try to look at them from a consumer's standpoint. Would you buy this item if you were not attached to it, if this was the first time you were seeing it? If not, then why would anyone else, right? So if you're not buying it, then no one else will. Also, do not underestimate the power of going back and looking at your Etsy conversations. See what shoppers are asking for and see what questions they had. Where can you make all of those inquiries more clear in your photos and your listing description? This is going to help you know exactly what to highlight or call attention to in your photos and your listing descriptions. Lastly, you can compare your listings to the top players in your niche. So basically, look what your top competitors are doing. What are they doing differently from you? And how can you improve based upon that comparison? Mistake number 2 is your SEO is not descriptive enough, diverse enough, or relevant enough. Diversifying your keywords in your titles and your tags really helps you because it helps you get found by more people. It helps you get found by an array of different shoppers that might be looking for the same product, but by using different keywords. So it's really going to expand your reach. Descriptive keywords will help you because they describe your item more accurately. So if someone stumbles across your listing based on a descriptive search term, then they're more likely to purchase from you because it's exactly what they were searching for. And relevancy is really important because when your keywords match exactly what a shopper is typing in the search bar, then it's more likely that your listing will rank higher in the search algorithm on Etsy. I use the Etsy SEO tool Marmalade to make sure that I am including keywords in my listings that people are actually searching for. So if you wanna try out Marmalade, then there's a link down below for a free 2-week trial, so you can go try it out. Mistake number 3 is your prices are just too high. If you are just starting out in your small business journey and your prices are the same or higher than what other people are charging that have been on the platform for a long time, then you really need to think objectively and think, why would someone buy my product when it's the same price or higher, when I have 0 stars and 0 sales, when someone who's way more established is selling it for the same price? So you have to really think about that. And does your price make sense from a consumer standpoint? So what I suggest you do is you can lower it, or you can put your items on sale temporarily, kind of like Think of it as a startup cost. So even if it eats into your profits, really just do this to start getting those conversions so Etsy can look at your shop as a valuable shop that people actually want to shop from. And then eventually when you start ranking higher in the search algorithm because you're converting, you can slowly raise your prices. And if you are super new to Etsy, I wanna let you know that I have a free new resource called the Etsy Success Roadmap. And basically I'm gonna take you through the three phases and the six steps that I took in order to make $2,000 a month passively and consistently. So if you wanna see how I did it, then you wanna go snag that free roadmap. I'm gonna link it down below. Mistake number four is you're not focusing on what's working. So a lot of Etsy sellers will actually just start to create more listings when they already have a couple of really successful products that are selling. So what I want you to do is take a look at your sales history. Do you see a pattern? Do you see similarities between these listings that are selling? What are they and how can you make more variations, maybe more colors, more styles, but still similar? So what can you do to just make more of these types of items? You also want to pay special attention to what people are saying in your Etsy conversations about these products that are selling well. So if someone is asking for something in blue and you only have it available in red, green, and pink, then you definitely want to add blue as an option. I'm telling you, this is something that I did. I just kept looking at the data and seeing what was working and kept making more variations. And that is really how I'm able to be successful on Etsy. So don't underestimate this. Please look at what's working and stop just trying to create something totally new every time you list something. And if you have no sales, then maybe you want to take a look at what is in people's carts and you can start there. So start tweaking and making those listings better or start making more variations of those types of products that are in people's carts. Also, a lot of the time, just running a sale really quickly on those really favorited items will help you make some conversions. So also consider dropping your prices or putting those items on sale just so you can start getting some conversions. But if you don't have any sales and none of your items are in anyone's cart, then it might just be because you don't have enough items. So you can definitely be successful on Etsy with just a handful of items. I'm talking 10 to 20 items, but it really depends on how niche your product line is. So when I was selling personalized champagne flutes, it was way more niche than, let's say, wall art, printable wall art. So I was able to be pretty successful with only 15 listings. But if I was to sell wall art, then I might need 50 to 100 to 200 listings. Really think about how many people are selling what you're selling. You can actually just go to the Etsy search bar and type in one of your keywords and see how many listings there actually are. If it's a really high number, then you might just not have enough in your shop. And lastly, mistake number six is you're relying on Etsy to drive all of your traffic to your shop. Now, I talk about content marketing on this channel and it's super important and I'm gonna briefly tell you why. So you have people that are product aware. These are people that know they want your products and those are the people that are going to Etsy and they're searching in the product that they want and they're finding your listing. But there are way more people that are actually just problem aware. So they don't know that your product is the solution. So if you create content surrounding your product, answering people's general questions about your niche and your industry, guess what? It's gonna drive a lot more traffic to your Etsy shop. So you don't wanna just rely solely on Etsy and Etsy SEO to drive traffic. You wanna make sure that you're at least on Pinterest and you really wanna consider creating a blog, a YouTube channel, or a podcast to drive that traffic to your Etsy shop. And speaking of driving external traffic, next week I'm going to post a video about my top three Pinterest hacks. These hacks are going to give you crazy amount of views on your Pinterest profile that eventually leads to your shop. So if you're interested, then subscribe to this channel and wait for the video next week. So those are the six big mistakes to avoid as an Etsy seller. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks so much for watching and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye guys.